New at 5, we're hearing from the families of two teens shot and killed in the Bronx. This is surveillance video of one of those victims, just 13 years old, stumbling into a restaurant after police say he was shot. We're freezing part of the video here because it's just too difficult to watch. The second teen was shot not too far away, and News 4's Erica Byfield joining us live now in the Claremont section of the Bronx. And Erica, I know you spoke with the victim's families, but first, what is the latest in this investigation?
Hi, Jen. Well, I spoke with police just moments ago. They tell me at this point, no arrests in either case. And while these shootings happen close to one another, at this point, police do not believe that they are connected. We had time today to spend with both of the mothers of both of these teens. As you can imagine, they are devastated, and they say they want answers. Ramon Gil Medrano's mother had a youngest, 16 is dead. Police say on Sunday he was in the Bronx in a taxi on 178th Street near Valentine Avenue when someone shot him point blank in the head and chest.
He died immediately.
But why?
I don't know why.
No sabemos.
We don't know why.
No sabemos. ¿Qué pasó?
We don't know what happened. We just want justice.
His family says that he was an aspiring rapper who loved baseball. They heard about it and were encouraged by Governor Cuomo's crackdown on violence, adding new teams to track guns. So they can't understand how, just days later, Ramon is gone.
He was on the phone with a friend when he got shot.
Yes, the friend heard the gunshot and then called my mom.
Oh my gosh.
It was horrific.
Sunday, a 13-year-old died too, shot walking down 187th Street. Surveillance shows Jerron Elliott in red pants. Shots zing through the air. Within seconds, he scrambles inside a restaurant. A crowd surrounds him. Police say he got shot in the ankle and chest.
It hurts me a lot, you know, that he was a nice kid. He was never a troublemaker. And then suddenly this happened to him.
Angie's one of the people who lit a candle in his memory in front of his Southern Boulevard building. Police think that his death is gang related. By phone, his mother called for peace and told me just how much she loves her son. Just like Ramon's mom, they want to know why this happened, left wondering, are they safe?
Necesitamos seguridad.
We need security.
The family police at this point are not saying if they think that first incident is connected to this one, which led to his death. We also found out from the family of the 13-year-old that today, around 7 o'clock, they say they're going to gather with his friends to remember him, the boy they all loved. Reporting from the Bronx, Erica Byfield, News 4, New York.